This is part 6 of the series how-to videos about AMS 4.0. This video learns how the AMC and AMS can be configured in case of emergency situations. We will cover a situation with a fire alarm. And we will show you how to evacuate with the help of AMS. At the end of this video, we also deal with a situation where there is a threat at the door. Let's first go back to where we ended in the previous video. The security company Roho and its office building. Remember our Roho office and its personnel? Remember Sokio Tanaka? She is the office manager. And is on working days the first person at the office. She takes place in office 2. Close to the entrance. From there she can keep an eye on all people coming in and going out. Remember the boss, Charles Smith? He sits opposite of Sukio, in office 1, and we had Gianna Garcia and James Williams. They are in office 3 and 4 respectively. So far a normal working day at the Roho office. But not every day is a normal day. Suppose there is an emergency situation. Every day an incident can occur. For example, a fire happens to be in the office, and an alarm might be triggered automatically from a smoke detector or a heat detector. Or may be activated manually by a fire alarm activation device. Then we want to immediately send out a warning signal. This could be a horn, a siren or a bell that informs people of a serious incident. Let's see how we can configure that fire alarming system in AMS by digital inputs and outputs, DIPs and DOPs. If the fire alarm is activated, it will close, open or pulse a circuit and send a wired input signal to the AMC. That is a DIP. The AMC recognizes the new state of the input and can send an output signal to the horn. That will be the DOP. From the main menu in AMS we navigate to configuration and then to device data. The system configuration is started. We right-click on the AMC controller to create a new entrance. This will be a special entrance, number 15. DIP DOP. The system allows 64 DIPs and 64 DOPs. But we need only one of each for this purpose. Let's expand the entrance so that we can see them. The DIP is the fire alarming device. The DOP is the horn. The entrance is simply called fire. Let's see where they are positioned in the terminal logic of the AMC. We notice that the input has gone to position 2 and the output to position 3. That were the first free positions. Let's put the DIP on the same level as the DOP. We unassign the fire alarm from position 2. And assign it to position 3. On the same level as the horn. Now we move back to the AMC. So that we can configure the DOP to follow the DIP. From the outputs we select number 3. The horn. Then we select input activated. As state. Now we choose input 3. The fire alarm. The AMC recognizes the new state of the input, fire alarm activated. And will send in signal to the output, start making noise. Next thing to do is connect the wires. In the next part we will configure and test how the fire alarm is reflected in the map view. In the map view, we will switch the office map in the edit mode so we can add additional objects. The fire alarm is mounted close to the entrance on the outer door of Sukiya's office. We select an icon that is somewhat representative. We have an icon for not set, push button idle, and an icon for set, push button pressed. The horn is mounted in the most central location of the office. The break room. We do not really have an icon that represents a horn. But we can use the per icon instead. That also has an idle and pressed version. Let's test by pressing the fire alarm. The dip top is listed in the alarm list twice, fire alarm and horn. And can also be watched when hovering the mouse over the icon. Threat level management. A threat can come from the outside or from the inside. Typically, when the threat comes from the outside, you want to block the outside doors. On the other hand, when the threat comes from within the building, you want the doors to be opened to facilitate smooth evacuation. In the AMS system configuration, we select the DMS entry and then the page threat level management. The name of our threat level will be evacuation. We can immediately activate it. On the page door security profiles, we will create a new profile and give it a self-explanatory name. The mode of this profile is unlocked. We want to unlock the doors. In the entrances page, we can select to what specific readers and doors we want to assign the policy. We choose the main door to assign the policy to, so that people can leave the building without obstacles. Now we can assign the threat level to an input. Therefore, we have to select an entrance. And that cannot be the dip top. So we select main entrance. We select a free input. For example, number 5. That will become the input that activates the door opening. The second free input is number 6. That can deactivate the door opening. And set the door control back to normal position. Now we will see how the just created threat will behave in the map view. Early in the morning, all Roho employees are present in their offices. It has been decided to hold a fire drill today. We want to check whether all procedures are working and whether the systems are doing their job. The fire alarm, the horn and the evacuation will be activated. If the fire alarm goes off, procedures dictate that everyone leave the premises. Gianna Garcia has left the building. John Williams has also left the building. Charles Smith is the third person who leaves. The office manager checks whether the building is empty and is the last to leave the office. Did everything work properly? Let's check. Fire alarm? Check. Horn? Check. Evacuation? Check. That went well. The evacuation on fire alarm has been tested successfully. Imagine the following fearful situation. An employee arrives at the office in the morning, and the moment she stands at the door, she is threatened. She has no choice but to open the door and let the assailant slip in with her. To identify herself, she has to present her badge and type in a PIN code. How can she unwittingly warn the operators of this predicament? So that they may have time to call the security, what the employee can do is enter a custom PIN code, which gives access but also sends a duress alarm to the operator. The prerequisite is that the reader requires a PIN code, and the person is in possession of a PIN code. Let's check that. Gianna and all other employees have assigned a PIN code that is equal to the last six numbers of her STN of her card and the ID number on her badge. The reader that lets us in, also known as outside in, requires a PIN code before opening the door. Despite the shock, Gianna remembers that by means of a small change in the PIN code, she can inform the operators of her dire situation. In fact, she has two options. She can either can type the PIN plus one, or she can type the PIN in reverse. She chooses the first option and types 453716. This gives her access, but also immediately sends a threatening warning to the operators. Also displayed in the alarm view. This concludes how to video number 6 that taught us how to configure, use and resolve three different types of emergencies with standard functionality in AMS 4.0.